Welcome, Detecting Brum Sisters. Here I am with my new ORX. Had a bit of a read of the manual to get an idea of how to work it. Not easy. Couple of pointers. One is that it's important to charge your search head before you pair it up with your control box. Now here we have a little plug with two little spikes in there, or plug things that goes into the actual search head, and they have to make contact before you charge up. It's got to go fully in. As you can see, if you see that, it's thin at one end, large at the bottom end, but it just fits exactly. It's on the actual search head itself, with the large bit going to the large clip at the back, or fitting at the back, fittings, yeah. And then it goes on. It's not easy, gotta tell you. Like that. So it fits on, making sure there's a connection point with the connection plug system inside, and that way it'll charge up, and then away you go, plug it in. Now this is a great little wire system. You've got three leads leading off on this, so you've got three, and that's for each individual remote control, search head, headphones to charge up through one USB, which is brilliant. So that's the charging point that's necessary with this clip. So you just go through the settings and programs, and find your pairing of each individual piece of equipment, your search head, control box, headphones, and pair them up. And it's same with the pinpointer, you pair it up, because obviously it's a nice bit of kit this. When the pinpointer switches on, this search coil goes off, which is brilliant. And then when you switch the pinpointer off, the search it automatically comes back on again. Nice bit of kit this, really good, like this. I love the design of it, to be honest. It's beautifully designed, strong metal, and you've got all these extension clips that extends fully. So yeah, brilliant. So it brings it really up to that level. So what we'll do now, we'll talk about the settings. So we'll show you the settings and the programs and how the actual control box works and the features, which is interesting. I'm just learning, so I'm just getting a basic idea. And then we're going to do some coin testing. So we've got the setting button, program button, switch it on button as well. And if you want to accept the speaker, or not accept the speaker, so if you don't accept the speaker, then it'll go straight to the headphones. So in this case, I'm just going to accept the speaker, because I want you to hear the tones when I'm going through the test of the target. So we'll say yes. And it's on. At the moment, it's just in factory setting of goal plus one. That's what it's doing at the moment. So we've got this button here that does the settings, so we'll go through the settings. If we want to select, in fact we can select it just to show you. Speaker is on, and then it goes through all the different functions. You can have backlight, 60, contrast, go to terrain, updates, language, etc. So we don't want to go through that lot, so we'll go through something else. And what you've got to do, you've got to put the serial number to the search head to pair it up. The other ones are straightforward. And then alongside it, you've got the programs, and then you can link up with the different devices. So if you can just see coil, so you link up with the coil and put the serial number in. Headset, link up with the headset, pin pointer, and it's back to configuration. So we want to go really into programs, so we'll go into programs. This actual button here, it goes back. If you make a mistake, you go back to A1. So let's just show you that. So we're on, go back to where we were. So we're on coil. So if you make a mistake and move to a certain level, you just use that arrow there to go back. So we need to then go to just messing a bit. There we go, it's on normal now. So let's just press it again to get through the programs. There's the program at the top. It's in, you can move the program to whatever you want. There's four different programs. At the moment we're looking at 4-coin depth. It has two empty users, so you can do your own input or fine tuning program back to your different. I've got it on 2 minus fine gold at the moment, so we'll just go that. I think we're on 24 kilohertz, that level. These two buttons here are the adjustments on your settings, minus and plus, and then this is the pinpointer. We've also got all these different displays. At the top is the program, we've got the search head, how much power in the search head, the right hand side, power on the control box, and then we've got ground level, it's not displaying at the moment, ground balancing, which is set up at 87, and we've got ground measure, which we've not set anything up just yet, but let's just get into. So now we're into settings. Middle button was a setting, and we've got sensitivity at 90. I might bring that down a bit. And then move it to frequency. It's at the maximum because I've got the large searcher at 25.4. Reactivity is at 2.5. I can lower that a little bit. That's like a mineralization level. And then we've got a discrim level here. So discrim is at 0. I might put that to 1. I've got iron volume. Well, I want to turn that off because I don't like it. It's on at the moment. So we'll turn it off. Off. So we've got threshold at the moment. That's on 0. We'll just move down sensitivity. So we're back to the settings. So that's how you do the settings. I'm going to put it back to now we're back to the main control features and menu. Okay, that's that then. Let's do some tests. Well, I've got the large search head on, as you can see, so now we've got a bit of foil. See what it makes? So what it sounds like on a bit of foil. So a bit of foil, that's good. A higher pitch, which is 90, if you can see it, that was 95 that actually. It's a buckle, and it's a low number for that. I go to a gold coin. 70,
Half a sovereign. You see that? And then we've got a large copper coin. Yeah, accuracy of that, that's brilliant. Look at that, beautiful. Same again, a big silver Victorian shilling. '60, '67 hammered. '72 depending on how close I'm getting it probably. And that's Georgia 6, threepence, copper, giving high reading, lead, 50s, the cover speed's brilliant on this, I love it, and that, look at that there now, that's 9 carat gold ring, ain't gonna miss that. '70, '79 Got a bit of mineralised stone there, nothing. Iron. An iron nail there. And I've got a sample of coke. Coke there, sample.
The disc scream on this goes from 0 to 99. I've looked at the manual and it says up to about 30s is coke and mineralisation. So I'm going to discrim it up to 30, and beyond 30 should be all the good stuff. So I have to save a lot of digging the coke and various other thin foil or something like that. Anyway, we'll try that and see how that works. So part 3 is going to be testing the machine out on some pasture. So I hope you can join me and catch you later. Cheers.